Welcome to Friday, Garrett. Thank you for your vlog on Ferguson. It was heart-wrenching to read everything on my news feed about it and hear people's reactions, but I almost feel like I'm unqualified to comment because I am a privileged white female, and what do I know of police brutality? What do I know of walking around and being afraid? You asked me if I was optimistic or pessimistic, and I'm gonna let you choose. 3, 2, 1, I'm pessimistic. You asked me if we're all gonna live or die, and clearly we're all gonna die, but just so you know just how pessimistic I am, let me tell you a little ditty I always think about all the time, just to make you depressed. The question, why are celebrities dying at rapid rates these days? Example, Robin Williams, and the next day, Lauren Bacall, and next week, someone else. Why is this happening? There's a simple reason. It's just because we know more people. We are aware of more people in the world. Think about it. In the 1920s, while movies were growing out of the black and white period, talkies were becoming more commonplace, television was having its birth, there was a big boom of personalities that the average person knows. Before that, it was like maybe they knew Rudolph Valentino, Mary Pickford, who the president was, who the prime minister of Great Britain was, the queen, but really normal people knew about like 100 people, including their family and friends. Nowadays, I personally know about 2,000 people. That's not even considering the thousands of celebrities, sports stars, authors, politicians, singers that I know that will probably die in my lifetime. I mean, if you think about it, if I live for another 60 years, then all those people will die. Let's just say 3,000 people over the span of 60 years, that's a lot of people. So in a way, Robin Williams died at a very fortuitous time before the real ramp of deaths are happening. I mean, think about it, in about like 40 years, everyone's gonna start dying. Brad Pitt, Obama, just everyone is gonna die, like within a couple year period. And what's the result of that? We're not gonna care as much. Like, we care a lot about Robin Williams today, but had Robin Williams died 50 years from now, we wouldn't care because someone like Beyonce would be dying. I don't know if I just made much sense. I might remake this video and upload it to my personal channel, but the point being here that I'm a pessimist and it's really hard to keep happy and excited, and I try my best, but this is why this is so great, because I get to talk to you a couple times a week and it lifts my spirits. Sticking with the pessimist theme, my question to you is, who are you gonna be really sad when they die? And don't say Peter Jackson, okay? And don't say any members of your family. For me, it will be Mel Brooks. The day Mel Brooks dies, you cannot talk to me. You cannot talk to me for the entire week. I don't know what I'll do with myself. Not that, no, not that. I'll be very sad. So, who are you gonna be sad to see go? One thing I am very excited about is my new camera. I just got the Panasonic Lumix GH4 and I am so excited about it. Yeah, awesome.